Hi, this is Suzanne Smiley with Atlas RFID, and we are here at RFID Journal Live 2014. I'm here with Debbie Power. How are you doing today?
Great, Suzanne. Thanks for having me.
Oh, we love having ThingMagic on, and she's going to take us through the ThingMagic products that they have at the booth this year. And there are tons of them, awesome readers. We've been selling hundreds. So can you lead us through what y'all have got going on here?
Sure. Absolutely. So, well, thank you for the opportunity. ThingMagic offers a range of UHF RFID readers. You can see some of them here. We have a couple of networked readers that run LLRP. We have a USB reader, and for commissioning, I'll take you all through those later, and as well as a very rugged in-vehicle oriented reader. And they are all supported with our Mercury API. They all read and write, and they all are supported with our Universal Reader Assistant tool for tuning and testing as you build your system design. This is the ThingMagic Vega reader, and this was designed for very rugged use. There's a version that, as you can see here, that has a pigtail that attaches to a car battery, so it's been shock and vibration tested. It has three antenna ports, and it can attach to a, as I said, a car battery. Okay. And it connects via serial interface to a computer that controls the reader.
Okay, is there another option for plugging it in?
Yes, there is. It comes in two variants. One is for a car battery or a battery on a cart, and the other is for, with a power adapter that you can plug it into the wall.
So okay, great.
That is the Vega. Very rugged. Next we have the Astra EX, which is our integrated reader with LLRP, again runs the Mercury API, and just to give you a little tour of it, the underneath part, we have here, I'll turn it upside down, it can get its power from PoE. So this is a very powerful reader. It can go to 31.5 dBm. It has GPIO input-output. You can use a power adapter to your wall or battery. It can be battery-powered. Here's the console port to connect to your PC for programming. And you can also put in a USB thumb drive for collecting data there as well. If I go to the other side, so it comes with one integrated antenna, and there's a port for a second antenna there. And one thing that's very unique about the Astra Wi-Fi is it has integrated Wi-Fi as an option. So this is the Wi-Fi antenna for this one, does have Wi-Fi. And it has some connectors here, so you can put it on a mount, like a TV mount, for adjusting and installing. And you can see it's a very unobtrusive package, so that it can look very nice in an enterprise. You can stick it up above a ceiling tile. And that's the Astra EX. Another one of our very powerful readers is the Mercury 6. Again, this can go up to 31.5 dBm even with PoE. It has integrated Wi-Fi as an option. It can accommodate four separate antennas, which can be separately controlled. It is a networked reader, so it can sit on your network and collect tag data, and then you can pull it either by Wi-Fi or by Ethernet. The PoE will give you the full 31.5 dBm, and again, it can be plugged into the wall with a power adapter or attached to a battery if you're going to use it on a cart. It's very rugged. It has four GPIO in and out if you want to trigger a light or a horn or a buzzer or use a motion detector to initiate a read, and it has a USB port for collecting data.
And it can also be mounted as well. It has little,
yes,
little holes.
Yes, it has these readers. And the M6 and the Astra EX, any software that's written for one will work for the other. So you can go back and forth if you have an installation that requires a variety of applications, installation requirements. If you have some that have four antennas and some that need two, you can use both of them. They also have an integral Linux processor. So if you have some program of your own that you want to put on here to do some tag filtering or for access control, is it a tag that I want to raise the boom to let a car into the parking garage You can put software on the Mercury 6 and the Acer EX. And the last one that I'm going to talk about is the USB Plus. So this is a reader that connects to a laptop via host USB port. See, there's a mini USB connector there, and that connects to a USB host port on your PC or your tablet. And it gets its power through that USB port as well as controlled by your PC. It is generally used for commissioning of tags. It's been used for point of sale. It can be used to write small quantities of tags. And it can be a very handy thing to just take around with you. It's got a 1 dBm antenna integrated into the box, so it can read about 3 feet away. But you can also dial the power down to get a shorter read range. It has some programmable buttons for if you wanted to read or write or take some particular action. And it has some lights that you can also light to show,
reading,
gotta read.
Writing.
Exactly. Yeah. So.
And those things fly off the shelf faster than you keep them in.
They're very handy. Where these guys are powerful, I would call this one frisky.
I like that term.
So, and it also has our universal reader assistant, which can make it a really nice tool for reading and writing small quantities of tags, seeing what kind of tag you have, if the tag has been encoded properly, that kind of thing.
Any last words on any of the readers you want to talk more about?
No, they're very high performance products. We have, LLRP, we have a range of products. They use our own modules inside, so we know they work really well.
Great quality.
Yeah.
Exactly. Great. Well, thank you so much, Abby, for taking us through the booth. We love being here and love being at RFID Journal. I hope you have a good rest of the time here and enjoy yourself.
Thanks, Suzanne.